Hello, and welcome to another tutorial on how to make the most of LessonPix. Today, I'll show you how to add your own photos to your LessonPix account so that you can use them in all our materials and templates. It's incredibly easy and very powerful. Before we get started, let's consider why we'd want to do this. After all, LessonPix has thousands of high-quality, scalable symbols that cover all kinds of subject areas. One reason is that we are simply missing something important to you. If it's something you think we should have, please tell us. You'll find the Request a Picture link on the toolbar. Click it and let us know what you need. All our best picture ideas come from our user requests, so don't be shy. We usually can turn around a new symbol in about a week or so, and we'll tell you when it's available. That said, there are other great reasons to add your own photos. For example, sometimes you don't need a picture of a teddy bear, you need a picture of Joey's teddy bear. Other times, you'll want to include pictures of people in your materials, perhaps for get-to-know-you games like bingo or playing cards. Our new system makes this really easy, so let's get started. First, log into your account and go to the Your LessonPix page. You'll see the section Photos You Uploaded and the link Manage My Photos. Go ahead and click it. On this page, you can add and manage your own photos. These photos are visible only to you. Nobody else on LessonPix can see them. You'll see two ways to add pictures. One is a basic upload function. You choose a picture from your computer, enter a title, and click Upload Photo. We'll add a picture of Gwen and set the title to her name. When LessonPix receives her picture, you'll notice that it's entered in the list at the bottom. Here you can change the title, copy it, remove it, or add it to your tray, just like any of our built-in symbols. You'll also notice that the picture acts exactly like one of our symbols. You can drag it to the tray, use it in our materials, and even export it if you'd like. All of our search tools work with your pictures as well. For example, we'll take a look at the sound finder and search for words with the weh sound. Gwen is shown right alongside the other words, with a yellow mine banner to remind us that nobody else can see the photos you upload. That's important to remember when you're uploading pictures of clients or students. And that banner will not show up in the materials you create, only when browsing and searching. Finally, we'll take a look at our most powerful photo tool, submitting pictures by email. This addition really adds unbelievable flexibility to LessonPix and has caused more than its share of wows when we show it at the conferences and shows. Every user at LessonPix has a username. In this case, we're logged into my account, which has a username of Bill. Every user also gets an upload email address, which is created by adding a dot and then a 4-digit PIN, which you can change to the username, followed by @lessonpix.com. So in this case, the address is bill.1234@lessonpix.com. This allows every user to add photos to their account directly from any device, app, or other piece of software that can send email. Let's take a look at how this works with a smartphone. First, we're going to take a picture with our camera. Then, we'll find the picture and email it by entering in our special photo upload email. In this case, we'll enter bill.1234@lessonpix.com. And you'll notice that that is saved for future use. Here we put in the subject, which will be used as the title of the picture. Our picture is a teapot, so we set that as the subject. Hit send and choose medium or any other size you want. Medium is fine. Your picture is sent to the system and automatically shows up in the Your Uploaded Photos list. Notice that the subject line of your email has been used as the title. This is a great way to quickly add all the pictures you need. We hope that this video has been helpful and that you have a great time using LessonPix.